Hey everyone, welcome back. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Tammy and this is Tammy's Nail Techniques. Today I'm working on a collaboration for Charlie's Nail Art Supplies, and I am a brand ambassador for Charlie, and one of the collaborations for the end of the month is bees. So that is what I'm working on today. If you're a first time person here, thank you so much for taking time to watch my video. And please consider subscribing. It would really help me out. Make sure you like the video and subscribe to or turn on your notifications, okay? And that would really help me out, and share the video so other people can see my content. Okay, so let's move along. First of all, what I have are my Young Nails cover stiletto nail tips. I'm going to be using those, and I'm going to get those up on my practice stand here, and once I do that, I'll be back to show you what else I'm using, okay? Hang in there with me. Okay, so as you can see, I have my stands all set up, and I'm going to run through a list of what I'm going to be using, okay? So first of all, I'm going to be using this new foil from Charlie's Nail Art. And I will put links on the screen or down in the description or whatever. And you can also use my code TAMMYR10, T-A-M-M-Y-R as in Riley, 10 for 10% off your order. This is one of her new releases for the month of May. It's Daisy Foil. I didn't have a lot, you know, to choose from in my nail art arsenal for bees. But I did have a few of Charlie's things, so this one is called Queen of Hearts, and I'm going to use this as the black glitter. It's a fine glitter. You can also find this on her website as well. As you can see right there, it's www.charliesnailart.co.uk, okay? And this one is called Queen of Hearts. So we're going to be using that and the Daisy Foil, and I don't know for sure, this sequin mix is called Wizard's Wonderland, but it does have some little butterflies and things in it, so I don't know whether I'm going to use that or not, but I thought I'd take a look at it and see. Then I've got this other glitter that's, I was really limited on glitter, so it's called Chicky, and then I have the smiley face glitter, but I'm not interested in the smileys. I'm interested in the fine glitter behind it, as you know, as the base. This is called Sony Smile Glitter. I'm not sure where I got it, but if I can remember, I'll put the link in the description. And then I'm going to be using, somewhere in the set, I'm going to be using a nail charm that I sell on my website. And that is www.tammysnailtechniques.com. And it is, this is out of one of my Spring Fling collections. This is the bee. Okay, and his wings glow in the dark. So I'm going to be using that in the set as well, okay? Because I didn't have any bee charms to use either. So I'm going to be using Phoenix Nail Co. Well, I don't know that I'm going to be using all these, but this one's called Sun Beam. Oops, there we go. I don't know that I'm going to be using them all, but I got out what I had available to me. And this is a Madame Glam color. This one is called Divine. And I'm going to be using Young Nails Black 101 and possibly Glitter Bells Hema Free. This one is called Banana Smash. Okay. Again, I'll link everything down either on the screen or down in the description box. But don't forget to use my code when you check out Charlie's site, or if you've already ordered from her, you know how great her products are and her customer service. Don't forget to use my code. Again, it's TAMMYR10 for 10% off. Okay, so normally if you were going to put these on a client or yourself, you would prep your nails as usual, and you would, you know, buff over your nail tips and, you know, put your base layer on first and cure that before you added your gel polish. But I'm not going to do any of that because I'm not putting these on anybody except in my display, okay? So, I think I'm going to start with Sunbeam. And I'm thinking that I'm going to start with the thumb. And this is like an egg yolk yellow. Or, well, I don't know. Maybe a more primary yellow, almost a jelly. But it reminds me of an egg yolk, of a runny egg. So we're going to do two coats of that. And y'all, I'm just winging it here. Okay? So, we're going to make it up as we go. I'm going to cure that in the light. I'm going to cure all these in the light. The only one I know for sure that cures in 30 seconds is the Madame Glam color. But just to be safe, I'm going to cure everybody today for 60 seconds. Okay? So I'm going to do two coats of that. And let's see. I think I'm going to use this one. This is the Banana Smash from Glitter Bells. And I'm pretty sure I'm going to, let's use that on the pinky and the index finger. And yeah, you're going to have to do two coats of this without question. So just give that a second to even out. Let gravity do its thing. And then we'll be doing the second coat of the other one on this one. While that one's curing, always try to keep moving, because that really saves time. Of course, it also saves time when you know that what you're going to do ahead of time, but I usually fly by the seat of my pants, so I know I probably should really plan out everything and, you know, write it down and draw pictures or whatever, but I don't know. All right. Okay, so that's the second coat of that. That's actually a really nice yellow. All right, this one's almost getting ready to come out. We'll do the second coat of that one. You could even do a third coat if you felt so inclined. But you know what? I'm just sitting here thinking. I don't know. I think that's too big. I don't know. Let's see. I think we'll leave that and put that in. And then I'm gonna leave those two for... I'm going to do two coats of that, of the Banana Smash on the index finger as well, and then I'll be back, okay?
But it sounded like it was coming off the wall from over there.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Great acoustics.
I don't know. I guess it could be casting sounds from the phone over there to the speaker.
You have a speaker over there?
Google Home something or another.
That's what it is, then. Stoodle-boodle. Damn it. Mistletoe. You let Mama do that to you, shame on you. But then again, if I had a fur coat like that, I'd want to shed it in the summertime, too.
Well, that ain't gonna work. Well, shit.
What?
I thought that would work, but it ain't gonna.
Right now, I guess I'm still, you know, partly in denial or whatever. Here we go. Found it. Can't put it in. Two gummies before bed. Melt belly fat. I don't think I got that problem. Here's one that's curious. Someone is sending you $1,000. Accept cash app transfer immediately.
No, it's a scam. Someone. Yeah, I like the way they put that.
Get results faster. Turn on unrestricted data usage in Google Go set. I don't think I'm going to do that either.
Yeah, unrestricted data usage.
Okay, here's one. Your results are ready. Golden State Warriors.
I don't know who that is.
Well, Golden State would be, I guess, California.
It's... And because it's such a narrow platform, it's not very powerful. I believe this is about 175 feet per second, okay? Now, Jorge Sprague over at the Slingshot Channel, shout out to you, brother. He created something. Fred! How did you get there, Fred? You know where I put you, Fred? Was a homage. Homage. Is it an homage? Okay, so that was an homage to I Am Legend. It's unfortunate we're not going to get an I Am Legend 2. I hope that Will Smith keeps it together. Please, we need I Am Legend 2, Will. Don't let us down. Anyways, I haven't signed it in. It's going to be very inaccurate, but we're just going to show you how it works. So, all you got to do is cock it, like we said before. Just like that. Be very careful when you cock it. It's going to be in a safety position. So the white fletching is down onto the rails. As I just demonstrated, you should never do that. You should never have your hand in front of it, like I just did there, just in case. And, yeah, we're going to put it into a fire position, and we're going to let it rip. So, like I say, if I can even get remotely close, I'll be surprised. Oh, it wasn't bad. Okay, guys, so there's many different ways that you can purify water in an emergency situation, but I assure you that you haven't seen this device that I'm going to show you today. I made a video on it about 4 years ago, only got about 25,000 views. If you want a more in-depth breakdown...
Only got 25,000 views. The editor to throw up a link right here. Poor him.
Now, what this is this allows you to make bleach, make chlorine out of just water and salt. And with chlorine, you can use that to purify water, killing pretty much everything that walks, crawls, slithers, except for cryptosporidium, which is a very hardy type of protozoa, which unfortunately you can't kill with this. This is called the Chlorine Maker SC200. This is made by the MSR company. They make some of the finest water purification devices in the world. They also engineered the MSR Guardian water filter, which is something which is used all around the world. So all you need for this is the machine. Just oil makes its way down underneath the barrel and, you know, underneath your...
Thank you.
check that. I'm doing good.
And it's conserving energy.
Which is, it should already have done it, but it ain't. We'll be right back.